What's up, everybody, and welcome back to Shred Show Part 2 today. We're just bringing you the best of the best, and today I am so excited to have new friend and guest Lindsay Lynn joining us because, let's just be honest, as handsome as Brian and I are, Lindsay's just way easier on the eyes. Plus, she's bringing you some things that you do not want to miss. Ladies and gentlemen, it is May, and it's Military Appreciation Month, and what better way to be talking about misconceptions, myths, and honestly, the benefits of VA lending. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to tag all your realtor friends, all your lending friends, anybody in our industry, you want to tag them because we're all about veterans today. And we're going to be talking about some things that are absolutely going to benefit our industry as a whole. Ladies and gentlemen, volume up. It is time to shred. So to be bringing you guys, Lindsay's a brand new friend, which I'm very, very excited about. Brian needs no introduction. Brian Burchanz of Caliber Home Loans. He is the VA expert. He is doing so much for veterans. He continues to serve. Plus, he's a veteran himself. He just got back from training. He was out there valiantly, heroically serving our country. So huge shout out to Brian and all he does for the veteran community. But Lindsay Lynn, a little background on her, and I'm excited to kind of have her share a little bit about herself. But she's actually the co-founder of Mill Housing. And for those who don't know what Mill Housing is, Lindsay, go ahead and share a little bit about Mill Housing and why you started it.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you so much, Josh. I appreciate this opportunity. And I want to say thanks to Brian for having me today. So Mill Housing Network, we are founded by two military spouses. So what happened when we went to go buy homes is we quickly discovered that not all realtors are created equal in all markets. What? We also quickly discovered that not all realtors understand what it means to work with active duty military families. So oftentimes active duty military families have a home they need to sell in one market and another home they need to buy in another market. And that usually happens within a span of 60 days. So what we quickly discovered, there is a need to connect military families with pre-screened realtors all over the world. And we are here to serve that need. And out of creating that, what we also discovered is that we have a huge opportunity to educate fellow realtors, fellow lenders on what it means to work with some of the best clients out there. And those best clients are active duty and veteran military families. So we're on a mission to make sure that we're connecting our military families with the right resources so that they can make the best decision possible when it comes to buying and selling a home.
That is awesome. I mean, what better way? And we were talking about this kind of as we were getting on. There is just so much misinformation. There are so many myths. There are so like, it's sad, number one, but that's why we're doing this. So that's why we're having these discussions because we want to educate. We want to educate real estate agents. We want to educate mortgage professionals alike because honestly, they go hand in hand. When the veteran is out there trying to buy a home, when they're trying to achieve that dream of home ownership, it's up to us as an industry to come together and to educate them on it. So I'm so excited about this discussion, which Brian, you're always about the veteran. You continue to push this. And this Operation VA that you and I are launching, this new series, we're actually going to be doing it weekly. Like that's how critical, that's how important we think this is, right?
Yeah, and you know, I know we had talked about doing this on Clubhouse, but I think this pivot is better for our messaging because, you know, not to discredit Clubhouse by any stretch, but it's just a one platform. You know, this needs to be out there on multiple different platforms, sending the message out as far wide as we can. Because the stuff that Lindsay brings to the table from a knowledge perspective on, most importantly, how to win in the market, right? So I think everybody, we have a lot of patriots out there. We have a lot of folks who really want to do right by the military or veteran. But I think where we all kind of come up short is how do we win, okay? Mm-hmm. And that's why we got to pull in as many people as we can to have these conversations and share best practices and collaborate on, you know, more ways to win for these folks.
Absolutely. And Lindsay, now more than ever it is such a competitive real estate market. It is so like our show actually earlier today, we had Rick Sharga on sharing some and Molly Dowdy sharing some really good topics of conversation. But with that being said, you know, how do real estate agents start to differentiate? Like, how do you actually help these veterans be competitive? How do we start to make that shift? And I know that you're actually working on a whole project behind the scenes to actually help educate realtors on that.
Yes, absolutely. And let's address the elephant in the room. I mean, homes are getting 42, 72 offers in one weekend after listing. Some of our favorite social media graphics. I don't know if you guys have seen the guy selling the apple, like literally that's the market that we're in, right? And, you know, as realtors and as a coach, I coach a lot of realtors in different markets. You know, we're constantly being asked, like, how can we differentiate for our clients? And creativity is winning. So for a lot of our agents out there, they're doing videos, they're doing, you know, when they submit an offer, they friend them on Facebook, they do a little video to say, hey, we're in your house right now, we're submitting an offer. Any little bit of creativity is going a long way in the market to differentiate yourself among 72 other offers. Some of them are, you know, 100,000 over asking. Now, you know, yeah, I know. So, you know, the need for education, creativity, constant ingenuity is out there. And one of the things that we're doing at Mel Housing Network is launching a platform for real estate agents so that we can start sharing some of the best practices that can help RBA buyers and sellers in this competitive market. Mm-hmm. We're going to be launching this platform. It's called Mel Housing Agent Network. And we're basically taking the best practices that we've learned, you know, working with thousands of military families over the past several years and making that information accessible to fellow agents in other markets that maybe don't do a high volume with VA clients, but they still need the education because, you know, our VA clients deserve to work with an agent that understands how to get their offer accepted.
Absolutely. And that's just it is I just don't think some people understand in this world of competitiveness. Like it is really crazy because I love that Apple video. I literally showed it on our show this morning because that's what the market is like. We had Molly Dowdy share that like she literally was like they had 70 something offers on a home and it's like 70 offers. Like, are you kidding? And she lives in a rural place. I can't remember where. Molly, forgive me. I know she's in Oklahoma somewhere. I know it's not Tulsa, but anyway, veterans in particular, like this is one of those things where they are so far, like it's almost difficult to even comprehend that when somebody's like, when a realtor sees a VA offer, they're like, oh, we're not even going to consider this offer because it's not a cash offer. It's not, you know, they automatically, because there's this stigmatism, there's this mindset. And Brian, you've seen this firsthand, you know that this is a problem. So these type of discussions, bringing us together and educating our entire industry of like, okay, let's sit down because we want to help our veterans. Our veterans, again, ladies and gentlemen, let's just state the facts of the matter. Wherever you stand, we live in a free country because of the men and women that protect us, that are absolutely, they're laying down their lives for us. And without them, we wouldn't have the freedoms. We wouldn't have the rights that we have. So it is our responsibility to help them achieve that dream of homeownership.
Absolutely. And one thing to consider too, if we want to just take the whole good business side of it, right? Like if you're just looking to increase your business, you know, less than 15% of eligible veterans have utilized their VA home loan benefit. So just hold that for a second. So 85% of the veterans out there are your potential customers. Jeez. So, you know, it's a shame that that's a real stat. However, just knowing that there's an 85%, you know, pool of folks out there who either A, don't really know about the benefit, or B, have unfortunately been shifted to another type of loan product. I mean, that's a big segment of people.
It is a huge, go ahead, Lindsay.
I was going to say, Brian, one of my favorite things that you do when you do your buyer presentation and you talk about the profile of a VA buyer is that there's so many agents out there that have this misconception that VA buyers have no money and that we are poor buyers, that we're not strong. So they take that misconception, now put them into a listing situation where they have a listing and now they're getting all these VA offers. So they automatically have this misconception like, ooh, you know, we're not going to go here. We're not going to even really consider this. But Brian, talk about the profile of a VA buyer because your stats are so strong when it comes to VA buyers.
Well, so thanks for bringing that up because that's a true statement that the average FICO score for military and veteran clients well into the 700s, right? Wow. I think 720-ish, somewhere around there. And so low DTI, high FICO, cash reserves, I mean, strong residual income. So, I mean, if you looked at just those stats and took loan program out of the equation, you would 100% of the time assume that that customer is a prime borrower. 100%. So now to, you know, Lindsay's, you know, point, unfortunately, I think we have folks who have some kind of snapshot in time of the 80s and 90s where maybe the VA clients, you know, credit profile might not have been the best. But fast forward to post 9/11, you know, financial management and all that good stuff just comes into play these days. And people just manage their money better in the military because they have to, because if they don't, they lose their security clearances and the military doesn't need them anymore. So there's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of responsibility to managing your finances in order to stay in the military. So I think you just see that behavior a lot. And then, you know, obviously they save money. And, you know, just because you're in the military or a veteran doesn't mean you don't sell your house and have a ton of cash to put down on another house. I don't understand where, like, there's this, you know, this, like, stigma that says that if you're a veteran or a military person, then clearly you can't sell a house and clearly you don't have any money and clearly you can't afford to live in my neighborhood.
Right. Well, and Brian, to the point of, like, you and I've talked, have discussed this in the past, not only do veterans have an upper hand because they can get 100% financing, but like you said, selling a home, now they have additional cash. So for those offers where they need to go a little bit above, they do have those cash reserves. So when those houses are going $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, even $50,000 over list price, they, again, they're already 100% financed. Like, they've got the financing, ching, now they've got the cash in, you know, in the bank to use for those. I'm not telling anybody, again, don't take that as advice. Don't go offer $50,000 above list price. Make sure you're talking to your local real estate agent. Make sure you're getting the value, making sure that it's going to be the best thing for you. Because that's the thing too, Lindsay, is I think that's something that's being missed in the real estate market right now, is educating buyer. Like, again, the market's crazy. Inventory is limited, limited than it's almost ever been. There are more potential buyers out there, veterans included, but sometimes, like, people are just throwing that Apple video is a perfect example. Sometimes people are just making offers and they're not the best educated offers. They're just be like, oh yeah, 100,000, extra 100,000 on top. And people are like, is it even worth that? Like, are you sure? Like, are you? So making sure you're working with a real estate agent is actually crucial in these moments.
Oh, 100%. And I'll throw you one more. If you're a VA buyer, make sure you're working with a pre-screened agent that has VA experience, especially in a market like this. You know, because, you know, you're making, you know, over asking offers. The reality of the matter is that the VA client is, if they're active duty, they're going to buy and sell probably 2, 3, 4 times during their military career, which is another reason if you're an agent watching this, and that, it's such a great market to serve, because the average civilian buyer buys a home every 7 to 12 years. So within the span of 12 years, a military family is going to buy and sell 3 to 4 different times versus one civilian client. So there's that piece as well. But for the VA buyers, you have to work with somebody that understands the market, that understands the market to the point where they're selling 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, you know, sales every single month in that market. So they understand the market trends, because you're not going to live in that house for longer than 3 to 4 years. Mm-hmm, right. You know, 3 to 4 years, if you use 100% of your VA financing, you're already upside down on the home when you close. So now we've got to make up that in the equity over the next 3 to 4 years. And if you went above asking price, now it's even more important that you're in a good home that's going to make that ROI when it comes time to resell. So working with an agent that understands that it has the reps in the market, that can give you the market information, because the reality of the matter is, you know, yeah, inventory is tight. It's still a great time to buy a home given the financing rates. If you can find a home, and there are homes out there, work with an agent that can help guide you along the process so that you understand the full breadth and depth of the transaction and that you make the best decision possible.
So a really good question came in here, Lindsay, is how can you actually find a screened veteran professional? How do you do that? Let's talk about that on the lending side. So Brian, and then Lindsay on the real estate side as well.
Well, here I go first. Well, I mean, there's a lot of organizations that do classes. You know what I mean? Like, I know NAM does CBLS, you know, Military Mortgage Boot Camp. And I know that Mike Fisher's got a segue to that with his new venture. I just think, you know, Caliber, we have our own internal stuff as well. So we have our own network of Caliber military veteran lending professionals who, you know, I think when you go through our stuff, we really have left, you know, no rock unturned. I mean, give you an example, that's why we hired Jeff Wilson. You know, Jeff Wilson, a 27-year retiree from the VA, and was the, you know, last loan guarantee officer at the Phoenix, you know, regional loan center. So having someone like him with his perspective on how to navigate VA only makes our folks even, you know, even better and sharper. So I don't think you really lose if you find someone that's been going above and beyond to take additional classes and learn. But the reality is this, you can read all you want.
Sure.
Okay? You can read all you want. It swings at the plate that gets you the real experience. You know what I mean? Like, you know, you can be well-versed on the handbook, but until you've experienced some of the stuff, you know, and experienced someone PCSing and experienced all the process that goes involved with the 10 days house hunting leave, people coming in, like, you know, trying to land a jet on an aircraft carrier. They don't have hardly any time and you're trying to throw stuff together. And, you know, until you've experienced all that, you know, that's the type of people I think you want to work with most of the time, especially if you're an active duty person trying to relocate.
Absolutely. See, those are all great points. So Lindsay, how about on the real estate side? Is there somewhere that, you know, veterans can go to find a qualified or somebody who actually understands VA loans?
Yeah. So shameless plug, go to millhousingnetwork.com.
Love it.
We have a concierge service that's 100% free for our military families. And what that means is you're working with a fellow military spouse that's going to connect you with the real estate professional, the lending professional. We've got movers, if you're going to do a partial ditty or a full ditty, which is a thing right now, given that COVID pushed all the moving facilities into this crazy havoc. So finding a mover, and a lot of people are doing more full ditties and partial ditty moves. So we've got discount codes for you guys that you can utilize through our network. So we've taken the legwork out of all of that process, and we've literally given you a streamlined one point of contact with our team that's going to guide you through the whole thing, and it's free.
Wow. Hey, that's not a shameless plug at all. That's like, that's beneficial right there. We're talking about VA benefits. We're talking about how to serve our veteran community better. And there you go, right there. So from Brian's, from what all that you shared, from Lindsay, what you shared, there are resources for you, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody out there listening, whether you're a real estate professional, whether you're a mortgage professional or a veteran, there are plenty of options. You just need to know where to go for. So, and that's why we're doing this. That's why Brian and I have set out on this journey. Operation VA is because we want to educate everybody. Because as we've mentioned multiple times now, we are in a more competitive market more than ever. So knowing your options, knowing how to best utilize those benefits is critical. And then, and it's simply, it comes down to some of the stats that you shared, Brian. I just don't think even veterans understand. With only 15% of them using their benefits, they just don't even know. So we just need more voices like yourselves that are out there spreading the word. And hopefully, as we continue to do so and use incredible platforms like we have, we can ultimately get to those veterans and we can ultimately serve them the way they continue to serve us so heroically. So I'm excited. Brian, do you have any more points you want to share today?
No, just looking forward to doing this weekly. We got lots of stuff weekly to talk about. There's been tons of changes with the VA home loan benefit. You know, I like, Josh, you and I have talked about this to we're blue in the face. I think the pandemic kind of overshadowed a lot of major changes like the Blue Water Navy law that went into effect
January 1,
2020. Removing the loan limits. We don't even talk about that stuff. And that stuff is like, I mean, you talk about just the winner, you know, win, win, win across the board for everybody, lenders, the market, the military folks. I mean, you know, realtors, everybody wins with that. Yeah. And we just don't talk about it enough. And, you know, just simple stuff like that with the National Guard now, you know, changes coming to their eligibility. I mean, there's a lot of things going on that we need to have conversations about so people are more equipped and can make informed decisions.
Absolutely. 100%. We're excited for it. And that's why we're going to be doing this weekly. And we committed Lindsay. She's going to be joining us monthly now. We're calling it live. It's going to be happening. We're going to have Lindsay on regularly. Cause again, she as a real estate, as a somebody who understands the real estate side of the industry, she's going to help us with that as well. And again, with all the work that she's doing with Mill Housing and all the things that she's doing behind the scenes, putting together this education for all of you, ladies and gentlemen, what better way to take advantage of that? So Lindsay, cannot thank you enough for joining us. Appreciate your shares. And like I said, we look forward to having you on a regular basis. It's happening, going down. So
I'm excited. I'm here for it and to spread the good word of what, you know, we can do within the military community, because it's a movement, Josh, right? Yeah. I want to make sure, and Brian alluded to this, We want to make sure that it's not about Millhousing Network. It's not about Caliber. It's about the VA community winning as a whole. And as we work together and as we tear down some of these boundaries, you know, we can all work together as professionals, realtors combined with lenders, all working to make sure that military families get into more homes. And that when military families get into more homes, the entire nation wins.
Absolutely.
Mic drop. We're out. That's it. What an awesome way to end. And that is what we're all about. And that's why Operation VA is go. We are launching it this month. Huge shout out to all our veterans out there. May is Military Appreciation Month. Tag a veteran below. Make sure you reach out to them and thank them for all that they've done for our community. Huge thanks again to Brian and Lindsay for all that they do for our veteran community. And like I said, we are just getting started. This is a movement, ladies and gentlemen, and we do need to band together so we can ultimately serve those veterans. With that, we appreciate you. We love you. Now it's time for all of you to go shred, go show up, hustle, repeat every day. We'll see you guys. Hey, what's up, everybody? Thank you again so much for joining us for today's show. If you like the content, make sure you hit that like button below. And if you already haven't subscribed to our channel, click right over here and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to see our latest video, click over here. And again, if you want to see the best of the best of daily content within the mortgage and real estate industries, you have to subscribe now. We look forward to having you shred with us every single day.